Hello friends, today I am going to explain about heating effect of current and Joule's law of heating. Before going to the topic of heating effect of electric current, consider a circuit which has a battery and a key and there is resistance connected to the circuit. Whenever I close the key, the current is passed through this resistance. When the current is passed through the connector, heat is generated and this effect is called as heating effect of current. So whenever the current is passed through the resistance, it gets heated up and this effect is called as heating effect. The first person who introduced this effect is called as Joule's law of heating. The person name is Joule. He is a scientist who invented this effect. Now we see the derivation of this electric circuit. How much energy is expended by the resistive circuit we are calculating. So energy equal to power into time. We know that power equal to voltage into current. So we are substituting this second equation in the first equation. So E equal to V into IT. We know from Ohm's law that V equal to IR. If you substitute this Ohm's law in this equation, we get E equal to I square RT. This energy is expended by the source and this used as heat energy. So we can replace energy with heat. I equal to H equal to I square RT, where I is current, R is resistance, is time taken. Joule's law of heating is stated as heat produced by the conductor is directly proportional to square of the current, directly proportional to resistance, directly proportional to time. So we see some practical applications where this heating effect is used. One of these is bulb. So what is happening is we have a bulb. It is inside that there is a tungsten. It is made up of tungsten material. Why we use only tungsten? Because its melting point is high, that is 3380 degrees Celsius. So it will melt at 3380 degrees Celsius, so very high. That's why we are using the tungsten. Okay, and when the current is passed through this tungsten, there is a heating effect according to the heating effect of current. So this energy from the input source is expended as heat and some part as light. That we see in houses the light because of heating effect. So another one is the fuse which we see in our houses. What is the function of fuse? Whenever any fault occurs at the outside, any substations or any due to rain, any short circuit occurs, heavy current flows through the circuit into our houses. That will damage our TVs, fridges, etc. So in order to avoid that, we are using a fuse. It is made up of small wire which is connected in series. It is connected in series with the circuit. So whenever a high current is passed through this wire, for normal currents, it will pass through the TVs, fridges, etc. If any short circuit occurs, high current flows through this wire, it gets heated up and the circuit was broken. So the current, IV current, will not flow to our houses. So this will help us to avoid break up the heavy currents. Thank you.